Hello folks, Mike Hoffman and the crew with you again this week. We're coming to you this week from Weakley County, Tennessee. As we travel across, we're proud that you joined us. Hang on because it's going to be a bumpy ride. We've got a lot of places that we're going to be touring, going to be promoting some tourism for you and showing you some neat stuff across Weakley County, Tennessee. As you can see right now, we're standing on the grasses of the historic University of Tennessee at Martin, my old alma mater. All I can say is, go Skyhawks. Don't y'all go nowhere.
From Union City, Tennessee, say hello to Mike Hoffman.
Your charity can lift you up while a good woman can take you down to your knees. And them good country songs sung by George Jones can make your woman aim to please. Well, it's songs like Yesterday's Wine and Still Doing Time that keeps your baby feeling just right. So mix your lady with some J.D. and song, and you'll have one heck of a night. Yeah, mix your lady with some J.D. and song, and you're bound to have one heck of a night.
Thank you.
Welcome to Weakley County, Tennessee, an area known for its rich soil, primed for a great harvest. Its friendly people, always greeting with a smile, and for its great history, a story that grows year after year. One Weakley County busy town is Martin, Tennessee, home to the Tennessee Soybean Festival. Every year, people of all ages flock to Weakley County to partake in the activities, which include, but are not limited to, a large parade that features everyone from a child's favorite firefighting animal to the young folks that draw in sports fans from all over, to art exhibits, rides, and yes, concerts. The Soybean Festival concerts have proven to be one of the largest fan draws of all of Northwest Tennessee, showcasing legends like Grand Ole Opry member Vince Gill and Rock and Roll Hall of Fame member Joan Jett. Downtown Martin, the festival's home base, has kept modern with remodels of historic storefronts and offers a rich shopping district with restaurants, clothing stores, gathering places, and business offices. At the center of downtown is the new Martin Public Library, currently under construction and slated to open in 2021. Venture uptown a bit and you can find the expanded commercial district that includes chain restaurants and national retail chains. Bridging the two districts together is the iconic University of Tennessee at Martin. A centerpiece of Weakley County, the school was established as the Hall Moody Institute in 1900. As you travel down US 45, the primary north to south highway, you will approach the small town of Sharon, Tennessee. A simple farming community, the first thing that caught our eye was a mural painted on the side of one of the grain bins. Everywhere you look, UT. As the center point of this county, this is a very accurate statement. Everywhere you look, you can see the impact that the University of Tennessee at Martin plays in the local community. Further downtown, there is a local mural depicting Sharon and storefronts open and ready for business. Once we completed our peaceful visit in Sharon, Tennessee, we travel to Big Cypress Tree State Park. Once home to the Tennessee Titan, the largest bald cypress tree in the U.S., this tree stood 175 feet tall, 40 feet in circumference, 13 feet in diameter, and was 1,350 years old when a major lightning strike killed the giant legendary tree. Another town along our route was Greenfield, Tennessee. Situated on the corner of Front Street and Hamburger Alley, you can find Wimpy's Corner, a famous Northwest Tennessee locally owned hamburger joint. Wimpy's features all beef hamburgers with that down-home style cooking that small rural towns in the South are best known for. Like many restaurants, they feature a challenge for their patrons. To take the Wimpy Challenge, you must eat the Double Wimpy, a 2-pound hamburger, along with an order of fries and a large drink. If it's okay with them, I think I'll just stick to the Junior Wimpy for now. Next stop, Gleason, Tennessee. Gleason is a small town in eastern Weakley County. Built near a large deposit of kaolinite, Gleason is a major producer of ball clay, a significant and necessary component in pottery production. Steel Plant Company, based in the small town, is Tennessee's largest sweet potato plant dealer. While all these towns have interesting claims to fame, a huge claim of the county seat in Dresden, Tennessee, is being the hometown of one of Tennessee's most memorable and popular governors, Ned Ray McWherter. In 1930, the former governor was born and raised in Palmersville, Tennessee, to sharecropping parents. Then, in 1964, he founded Volunteer Distributing, Northwest Tennessee's official Anheuser-Busch distributor. McWherter became active in politics in the 1950s, and in 1968, he ran unopposed for the Tennessee House of Representatives. Then, in 1974, Ned Ray was voted as Speaker of the House. He quickly rose in state and national politics and, in 1986, sought the Democratic nomination for Governor of the State of Tennessee. In January 1987, Ned Ray McWherter swore the oath of office as the 46th governor of Tennessee, succeeding Governor Lamar Alexander. As governor, McWherter accomplished much during his time in office, passing the Sunshine Law, making all government proceedings open and transparent, education reform, and implementing TEN Care. After two terms, the governor retired to Dresden to carry on his Italian Renaissance mansion. In 1997, he donated the land and money to build a new library for the citizens of his hometown. The Ned Ray McWherter Library and Museum is next door to his home in Dresden, Tennessee today. The governor died in 2011 from cancer and is buried in his hometown. You can learn and see much more about this topic and Weakley County as a whole by stopping into Dresden, Tennessee, or by visiting www.weakleycountytn.gov/library. General information, including hours of business, are posted. No matter one's political party affiliation, at the end of the day, we're all Americans. During this Weakley County series, I was privileged to stop by Governor McWherter's Museum just off of Linden Street to visit with the library director and to perform a song recognizing all Americans. Some have said, down through history, if you last, it's a mystery. But I guess they don't know what they're talking about. From the mountains down to the sea, you become such a habit with me. America, America. Well, I come from down round Tennessee, but the people in California are nice to me, America. It don't matter where I may roam, tell you people that it's home sweet home, America, America. And my brothers, all black and white, yellow too, and the red band is right to expect a little from you. Your promise and then follow through, America. And the men who fell on the plains and lived through the hardship and pain, America, America. And the men who just could not fight in a war that didn't seem right, you let them come home, America. And my brothers, they're all black and white, yellow too, and the red man is right to expect a little from you, to promise and then follow through, America. Well, I come from down round Tennessee, but the people out in California are nice to me. America. It don't matter where I may roam, tell you people that it's home sweet home, America, America. And my brothers, all black and white, yellow too, and the red man is right to expect a little from you. You promise and then follow through, America. You let them come home, America. Oh no, it's home sweet home, America. Well, good day again, friends. We sure hope that you enjoyed what you just saw. We appreciate you tuning in. Listen, don't forget to subscribe, or you can check out any of our other videos at any time that you'd like. Once again, from Mike Hoffman and all the crew, don't you go nowhere.